The Fraser family's apartment was shot up, and there were kids and a pregnant mother inside. This time, a man was shot five times and rushed to the hospital. Fox 13's Zach Crenshaw talked with that family on Friday. He joins us live right now. And, Zach, you had to go back to that same apartment complex tonight to find out what's going on here.
And there was a very different feeling this evening, Daryl. When I was there on Friday, there was an uneasiness, but people were still outside and talking to me. Today, when I went back after yet another shooting, there was palpable fear.
Timberridge Apartments seemed abandoned Tuesday. Unit 8 was boarded up, not because of an eviction, but bullet holes from two different shootings in 4 days.
The family told me on Friday that they were staying at hotels some nights ever since 8 shots were fired on Wednesday. Then on Sunday, though, they were back here at their apartment complex when 12 bullets ripped through yet again.
The windows, which had holes in them on Friday, were covered with plywood today. The Sunday shooting left damage of its own, 2 bullets in the front door. At least part of the family was in the living room when the shots rang out. One man was hit 5 times. A girl was rushed to Le Bonheur after cutting her eye, and a pregnant woman was also transported because of stomach pain. Outside, detectives found 12 shell casings from 2 different guns. They say the shooters fired from different sides of the apartment. I went to the main office to ask management what they were doing about security and safety. No one answered, and I was asked to leave.
I spent over an hour trying to talk to people at this apartment complex. Not a single person wanted to go on camera. The reason why? They said they were scared and weren't sure what was going to happen to them. What did you do when you heard the gunshots?
I fell and I hit my head on the couch.
How long did it last?
Like 30 seconds.
That's what an 11-year-old boy told me on Friday. I asked him then what he was thinking.
I'm like, what if they do it again? How is somebody going to get hit if they do it again?
In his first week of summer, that little boy's worst fear was realized. Now the family's living in constant fear. And the shooters are on the run.
Now, there's very little suspect information from either of those shootings. Witnesses told police after this second one on Sunday that they saw 4 males in a black Suburban. There are cameras there. We actually saw some workers working on those cameras, cleaning them, doing routine maintenance, they said. But certainly they want those working, and police will be going over those. We will let you know if we get any suspect information. Of course, if you have any information, detectives are asking you to pass that on. 528-CASH is the number for Crime Stoppers. You will remain anonymous. Reporting live tonight, Zach Crenshaw, Fox 13 News.
All right, thank you for that update on this story, Zach.